I am the result of an experiment that went wrong. Whenever a chick would call me a bastard while we were fucking, my dick would become 4 feet long. Yeah. I'm gonna tell you the story of a scientist who experiments with very hard. He dreamed of creating a formula that would make men's dicks stay hard. He advertised in a paper for some lucky guy who needed a gig. So I went to apply for the motherfucking job, not knowing I would be a guinea pig. He said, just stay calm. I promise you, you won't get hurt. I've tried this shit on frogs and hogs, and I tell you, goddammit, it worked. He said, you see this shit here in this needle? It's gonna change your old motherfucking life. He said, when I get through with that prick of yours, I'm gonna let you try it out on my wife. Yeah. I said, what? Yeah. She laid down and spread her legs and said, boy, come on in. But when I pulled my dick out, the hoe began to grin. She said, degrade myself with something like that? Huh, not me. She said, you may not believe this, but I've seen bigger pricks on a flea. And that made me mad. Yeah. So I climbed up on top of this bitch, and I put my dick into the hilt. I said, just lay back and get ready, bitch, while I give you some of my feels. The cunt on this bitch was so fucking big, I swear I was like fucking out of space. And after I put my dick in this bitch, I think I was up to my waist. I said, help somebody! She said, fucking something like this, I tell you, is a disaster. Then the bitch wrapped her legs around my waist and said, fuck me, you fucking bastard! Suddenly something strange began to happen to me as my prick began to rise. It grew and it grew and it grew and it grew to 80 times the size. She started to scream as I shot a load in her as her pussy broke up like glass. It came out of mouth and her eyes and her nose and out of the crack of her ass. She hollered and screamed and hollered as she began to shit. But this 4 feet 10 inch prick of mine had tore her pussy to bits. Yeah, the incredible fuck. Incredible fuck. I told my friends what had happened and they thought it all was lies. So I dropped my pants to show them my prick, but it was back to its normal size. I tried to tell them what had happened, but they swear that I must be wrong. They said, how could a pussy be so ripped to bits by a prick only 2 inches long? Yeah, I couldn't understand that shit for goddamn sake. Suddenly, hoes from everywhere came running and found out if it was true that a dude with a 2-inch prick could make a walls of a chick pussy came through. It was true all motherfucking right. And they was dying to find out. Yeah. The incredible fuck. It was too big to suck. I had to carry it on a truck. Oh, what motherfucking luck. Then one morning I read in a paper something that made me sick. Some dumb crack was giving $1 million to anyone with the biggest prick. And suddenly it occurred to me that money's what I've been after. I can win this shit if only I can get someone to call me a bastard. Yeah, the incredible fuck is what I will be. Talking about minerals and protein, man, my dick was full. So I went on and entered the contest, not knowing I had to compete against a bull. There was also a dinosaur, a hippopotamus, and a gorilla. And just when I thought that I had it made, I looked around and there was Godzilla. I started to get scared. My knees started shaking. Yeah. The judge was a redneck. He said, all this motherfucking shit I master. He said, drop your pants and show that prick of yours, you nigger bastard. In itching I did that goddamn shit. Suddenly horns grew out on my head. A devil tail grew out behind. My eyes crossed all up and shit. Train smoke started coming out my nose. And that prick of mine started to rise. And rise. And rise. And rise. And rise. Till it was taller than the Empire State Building. The shit was sticking up in the air so far. Planes had to reroute themselves to keep it running into it. The moon had to get off its axis and go the other motherfucking way. Because that prick of mine was way up there in the atmosphere, you queer. And I won the money, honey. All of that shit. And then I looked around. And that was the dinosaur. Man. And that was Godzilla. So you know what I did then? I rammed Godzilla in the ass. And then I got a hold to the bull. I turned his motherfucking ass in a cellar and steak, which left my refrigerator full. Yeah! The incredible fuck. Gotta carry it in my truck. What motherfucking luck? It's too big to suck. I like to say something about a friend of mine who swears that he can rap. He talk all kind of shit on the radio like his motherfucking lips got the clap. The motherfucker that I'm rapping about, I'm sure that you all know. All the faggots call him darling, but you know him as Curtis Blow. He think he's good, he think he's it, but I'm here to tell you that he ain't shit. Cause his ass can't take what his ears receive, cause I come on his mind and make him weak in his knees. Play this woman pussy till her hair turn red, make her jerk up her dad and give her mammy some head. Keep her coming till it ain't none left, cause I can fuck so good I wanna fuck myself. I go ooh. I go ah, I go ooh ooh ah ah ooh ah ah ooh. I go ah, I go ooh ooh ah ah ooh ah ah. Yeah. And this is the way he said. He got a little shit to my. I said do it. I said do it. I said do it. Do it. Do it. But that doesn't compare with this motherfucking head. He go ooh. I go ah. I go ooh. I go ah, I go ooh ah, ooh ah ah, beep beep bum bum, ooh ooh come come, ooh ah ah, ooh ooh ah ah. Now whenever I appear in your town, and my prick all you chicks are after, if you don't want your pussy toned to threads, don't call me a bastard. The incredible fuck, I have to carry it in a truck. It's too big to suck. What motherfucking love? Yeah.